Oh, good evening, everyone. We are in the middle of a fantastic stretch of weather. Does it get any better than this for northern New England in October? Lots of sunshine, comfortable temps around 60 degrees, and it looks like it continues Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Just a few showers are possible on Sunday. But if we were to see that major impact with what now is Hurricane Sandy, we would see that Monday into Tuesday. So I want to focus tonight's weather extra on that part of the forecast. Of course, by now you probably heard about Sandy. It's a household name. The good news, I think it's gone by Halloween, even if we were to get the storm. The joke earlier today was last Halloween we were trick-or-treating in snow boots. This Halloween, if Sandy affects us, we'll likely be trick-or-treating, or we could be trick-or-treating with power outages or no power out there. So let's see what's happening right now with Sandy. Sandy has sustained winds of 80 miles per hour, Category 1 storm, affecting the island of Jamaica this afternoon. It's about 25 miles to the north of Kingston, Jamaica. Hurricane warnings have been issued for portions of Cuba, the Bahamas. Tropical storm warnings have been issued for the tip of Florida as well. Let's take a look at the official Hurricane Center's track of the storm. The track has shifted a little bit further to the west as anticipated. The storm is expected to be located a few hundred miles south of Cape Cod with sustained winds of 60 miles per hour, gusts to 75. That's Monday, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. There's that cone of uncertainty. It could be further off to the east, or it could be affecting areas like New Jersey, as far west as New Jersey, or maybe even Delmarva, which is certainly a possibility if you believe the European model today. That will be Monday into Tuesday. Now, the big question is it purely tropical? Is it exotropical? Is it one of those hybrid systems like the perfect storm back in 1991? It's my opinion it'll probably becoming extratropical during that point, and the wind field should be allowed to expand during that extratropical process or when it loses its tropical characteristics. Therefore, I don't think it really matters if the storm moves into areas like Long Island or even New York, because we would see some strong winds even here in Maine, very strong winds, potentially tropical storm, maybe even hurricane force with that scenario. In fact, we saw that with the Patriots Day nor'easter. That storm was centered over Connecticut, and we still had hurricane force winds along the coast here of Maine. Let's take a look at a few of these forecast models. These are the spaghetti plots. Each one of those little lines indicate a different forecast model and their projected track. Yesterday, a lot of these were taking the storm out to sea with only a few curving them back up into the northeast. Now, many more curving them back up into the northeast. So it's looking more and more like we are going to see an impact with rain, wind, the potential for flooding, and power outages. That is the official Hurricane Center's track right there. Each one of those little lines is a different computer model. So how is this going to play out here? Well, the storm moves over the Bahamas Thursday into Friday. There it is as a hurricane, is expected to become a tropical storm after that, moving into Saturday. I want to stop this. I believe this is Monday I stop it here around 7 o'clock. Still a few hundred miles to the south during this period. An extreme threat to the northeast appears to be brewing here. The big question is it going to take a track like the GFS, which I don't think it will, right into the state of Maine? That would be a horrible scenario. In fact, I've never seen a track like that, but not to say it won't happen. It's just an extreme storm with a crazy track there. It's probably more likely going to be something like this, and I'll show you some of the other forecast models that indicate that track right here. In fact, let's take a look at a few of those models. Let's start out with the Canadian GFS track. This is the GFS track right here. This would be a horrible scenario. Hurricane force winds, we'd see a tremendous amount of flooding along the coast, and you know what? The tides are running astronomically high next week either way, so we'll probably see some coastal flooding as well. But this is a storm with the central pressure comparable to a Category 2 or 3 hurricane making landfall in Maine. This is one computer model, so I don't want to get anyone too excited about this. This is the GFS model, which has been out to lunch and is probably still a little bit out to lunch. But the important part is it's shifting west. It keeps shifting west, which we expect it to do. And there it is, Monday, Tuesday, and into Wednesday. Let's get rid of that here. Now I want to show you the... what's this one? This one, I believe, is the Canadian track. Yes, there it is, the Canadian track. The storm is probably a hurricane right over Cape Cod, and that's probably just a little too far to the east, a little too far to the north as well. I think the storm's going to take a track something a little closer to this, and it's still too early to say at this point the exact track because we're still 5 days out. This is Sunday night, quite a bit quicker. This is Sunday night. I don't think it's going to come in Sunday night. It's probably a Monday, Tuesday storm, but this is the no-gaps model run through our U.S. government, our Navy, I should say. This is a storm that's centered right over Long Island or moving into New York City at that point, we would get that counterclockwise rotation around low pressure that would bring in a strong, strong wind coming in off the ocean. This one right here is, let's see, this one's the European model, and I'd use caution when you look at these isobars, instead of every 4 millibars, they're every 2 millibars. That's why it looks like a giant dartboard. But this storm is centered very close to Atlantic City, New Jersey, somewhere in there, New Jersey storm. That might be a little too far to the west, but you see this model continues to trend further off to the west. That would be a significant impact either way. Here we are now with the Japanese model. This has been a rather consistent model over the last several days. Storm moving inland right along Connecticut or Rhode Island, possibly as far south there as New York or Long Island there. The storm moving inland here. This is about 8 o'clock on Tuesday morning. So the good news, it looks like the worst of this will be done by Wednesday, our Halloween, our trick-or-treating. We'll have to see if we actually have our power for Halloween. But regardless, a significant impact appears to be in the works here. The impact being strong wind, power outages, flooding for not only coastal but inland flooding as well. And the time frame for that will be Monday into Tuesday. That's my latest information, or that's the latest information on my latest thoughts on how this storm's going to play out. I'll have updates tonight on News 13 to 11. I'll see you then. Hope everyone has a nice night.